What's up, Linux fam? Welcome back to Tun Does Linux and More. And folks, what a week! Seriously, if you thought the Linux world was moving fast before, this past week just hit the nitro button. We're talking about a proposal that could fundamentally change how the Linux kernel works, forever. A brand new, shiny GNOME desktop officially landing, and a move from Canonical and NVIDIA that is going to make life easier for, well, pretty much everyone doing serious work on Ubuntu. You're not going to want to miss this. We've got a packed show, so grab your coffee, pop open a terminal for fun, and let's dive into the biggest Linux news from the third week of September 2025. Alright, let's kick things off with the heart of our systems, the Linux kernel. And the big story is that Linux 6.17 is right around the corner. Linus Torvalds just dropped the 7th release candidate, and he said that unless something, and I quote, odd, happens, this is the last one before the final release. So we can expect to see the stable version of 6.17 hitting the streets as early as next week. Now 6.17 itself is packed with goodies, which we've talked about in previous videos, but some interesting last-minute additions include better power management for upcoming AMD platforms and improved thermal monitoring for some of those cool new gaming handhelds like the AOKZ and 1X player. So better battery life and less toasty hands. What's not to love? But that's not even the most exciting kernel news this week. Not by a long shot. A company called Multi-Kernel Technologies just dropped a proposal, a request for comments, on the kernel mailing list for a multi-kernel architecture. Now, what on earth does that mean? Well, look at this diagram. The idea is to run multiple independent Linux kernels on the same machine at the same time. Each kernel would get its own dedicated CPU cores, but share the rest of the hardware, like RAM and storage. Think about the possibilities. You could have a general-purpose kernel for your day-to-day desktop stuff running right alongside a super stripped-down, real-time kernel for audio production or industrial control, and maybe even a third, super-secure kernel for handling sensitive data. All on one machine, without the overhead of traditional virtual machines. This provides incredible fault isolation and security. It's a wild idea, and while it's still in the very early stages, the potential is just massive. This could be a game changer for everything from cloud computing to embedded systems. We are going to be watching this one very closely. Well, and of course, we also got a flurry of stable kernel updates with new point releases for 6.16, 6.12, 6.6, and 6.1. So as always, make sure you're keeping your systems updated, folks. From the kernel, let's move up the stack to the distributions that bring it all to our desktops. And it has been a beta bonanza this week. It feels like every major distro is giving us a sneak peek at what's coming this fall. First up, we have the betas for both Fedora 43 and Ubuntu 25.10. No surprise here, both are shipping with the latest and greatest, including the Linux 6.17 kernel and the brand new GNOME 49 desktop, which we'll talk more about in a minute. So if you want to get on the bleeding edge of the two biggest names in the Linux desktop space, the beta ISOs are out there for you to test. We also saw the beta release of Zorin OS 18. The Zorin team is known for their polish and making Linux accessible, and this release looks to be no exception. They're teasing a refreshed look in some really slick advanced window tiling features. If you're a fan of clean, beautiful desktops that just work, Zorin 18 is definitely one to watch. And for all you Debian lovers out there, the beta for Linux Mint Debian Edition 7, or LMDE7, is now available. Codenamed GG, this is for the folks who love the Cinnamon desktop and the Linux Mint toolset but prefer the rock-solid stability of a Debian base. It's a fantastic project, and it's great to see it getting a major update. But it wasn't all betas. The privacy-focused distribution Tails dropped a major new stable release, Tails 7.0. This version is now based on the upcoming Debian 13 Trixie and brings in GNOME 48. For those who depend on Tails for anonymity and security, this is a huge and important update. Alright, let's talk about the eye candy. What? The desktop environments that we interact with every single day. And the big news, the one we've all been waiting for, is that GNOME 49 codename Brescia is officially out. As expected, it's a release packed with refinements and new features. The developers have been hard at work polishing the user experience, improving performance, and adding more capabilities to the core apps, we're seeing a more refined settings panel, some really nice updates to the file manager, and a whole lot more. We'll be doing a full deep dive review of GNOME 49 very soon, so make sure you're subscribed for that. But the GNOME team isn't the only one that's been busy. The folks over at KDE have just released the public beta for Plasma 6.5. Plasma 6 has been a fantastic release, and 6.5 is looking to build on that with even more polish and features. The beta is your chance to help test it out and report any bugs before the final release. If you're a KDE fan, now's the time to get involved. On the application front, Mozilla pushed out Firefox 143 this week with a bunch of security fixes and improvements. And the beta for Firefox 144 is already showing some interesting new features, including stronger encryption for the built-in password manager. It's great to see Mozilla continuing to push forward on privacy and security. Now, let's talk about the hardware that powers our Linux machines. And the biggest news on this front is a massive announcement from Canonical and NVIDIA. They are officially bringing the NVIDIA CUDA toolkit into the main Ubuntu repositories. This is a huge deal for developers, data scientists, and anyone working with AI and machine learning on Ubuntu. For years, installing CUDA has been a multi-step process involving downloading a massive installer from NVIDIA's website and dealing with potential driver mismatches. It was a pain. Now, it's going to be as simple as sudo apt install CUDA. That's it. This is going to make it so much easier to get up and running with GPU-accelerated computing on Ubuntu. It's a fantastic move that shows a deep collaboration between Canonical and NVIDIA, and it's a huge win for the entire Linux ecosystem. On the AMD side of things, we're seeing continued work on improving power efficiency. New patches have been submitted for the Linux kernel to add support for ACPIC4, a deeper power-saving state. This should translate to better battery life on AMD-powered laptops. And as we mentioned earlier, the kernel is also getting better support for new gaming handhelds, which is always great to see. And for Intel users, there are new power-saving options being added to the Intel graphics driver for the upcoming Linux 6.18 kernel. So no matter what hardware you're running, it's a good week for power efficiency. And finally, let's take a look at what's been happening in the broader Linux and open source community. And the big buzz is all around System76's new Cosmic desktop environment. We've been following the development of Cosmic for a while now, and it's looking absolutely fantastic. It's a brand new Rust-based desktop environment that promises to be fast, customizable, and TBOR driven. And the exciting news is that the beta for Cosmic is expected to land on September 25th, alongside the beta for Pop! OS 24.04. I know a lot of you are incredibly excited to get your hands on this, and I am right there with you. We will be doing a full in-depth video on the Cosmic beta as soon as it drops. In other community news, the Arch Linux installer has graduated its LVM support out of beta. This makes it easier than ever to set up more complex storage configurations on Arch. And the KDE community gathered in Berlin for their annual Academy conference, where they discussed the future of the KDE project and celebrated their recent successes. And that's a wrap for this week, folks. What did I tell you? A multi-kernel future, a new GNOME desktop, and CUDA just an apt install away. The pace of innovation in the Linux world is just relentless, and I absolutely love it. It's an exciting time to be a Linux user. What are your thoughts on all this news? Are you excited about the multi-kernel proposal? Are you already downloading the GNOME 49 beta? Let me know in the comments below. I read every single one. If you enjoyed this video and want to stay up to date on all things Linux, make sure you hit that subscribe button and ring the bell so you don't miss a thing. And if you really want to support the channel, check out the links in the description. Every little bit helps. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.